Can't wait to show you how to design and then print and cut these super cute sticker sheets. And I'll be showing you how you can use free elements in Canva and a few pro tips too. And then we'll be printing and cutting them out in Cricut. So let's get started. So to make these sticker sheets, you will need Canva. You will either have a free or a pro account. There are definitely things that are easier with a pro account, but I will show you some workarounds if you only have the free one. You're also going to need some graphics or clip art to make stickers, and you can find all of those in Canva. You'll need white matte sticker paper to print your stickers on, and then a Cricut cutting machine. But if you wanted to cut your stickers out with scissors or a craft knife, you can. And if you have a silhouette or a different cutting machine, I'm sure you can apply these same techniques. The first thing we're going to start with is this template that I've already created for you. And this has two different sticker sheets that we'll have side by side in a landscape view on a sticker sheet that we'll print and cut. And I made these a measurement of 4.55 inches wide by 6.75 inches high. Now, the reason that I did that is because I can then fit two next to each other and they will fit into a nice space when we upload them into Cricut, because the total space that we can print and cut with my Joy Xtra needs to be no bigger than 6.75 by 9.25. So I used a frame, I added a frame, and then I resized it by clicking position and then resized it to 4.55 by 6.75. And with this frame, I can now drop in any colors or patterns to make these sticker sheets really stand out. I also added a block bar at the top and the bottom that I could add my logo and my website URL onto. This is great if you're making stickers to sell. So to do that, I went to Elements, then Shapes, and then Square, and I added a square. You can change the color of that, and then I resized it so that it fitted perfectly at the top and the bottom. Now it's time to add a fun pattern onto our frames. So I'm searching for a snowflake pattern. I also filtered the search by free because I wanted to show you some really fun free elements in Canva. Then you just drag and drop that into the frame, and it's such a beautiful way to make a sticker sheet that stands out. Of course, you can upload your own patterns too. So I've uploaded loads into Canva and then just drag and drop them into the frame. We can now recolor those two bars at the top and the bottom, and you can just color pick from the pattern, so it's a really cohesive sticker sheet. I'm adding my logo to the top, and then at the bottom, I'm going to add my URL, minjenkinson.com. Now, the reason I'm adding a snowflake background is because this is the sticker sheet with my little penguins, and I wanted it to be a wintry, festive theme. I'm going to graphics again, and I'll type in penguins. So I've found my penguin, and when I click on this penguin to add it to my canvas, it's now coming up with the magic recommendations. Not all have this, but this is a really great way to see if there are any other elements that match. So there are four different penguins here, and these four penguins are so cute. And I'll also add a white border around them, an offset. And to do that, you can either do it in Cricut later or now, but you just click on each of them, go to Edit, Shadows, and you're adding an outline shadow. So after I'm resizing these penguins, I'm going to duplicate them because there's plenty of room to add even more than just the four. And now it's a really fun puzzle game where I'm rotating them, I'm moving them, and I'm arranging them into a lovely sticker sheet that maximizes the space on the sheet. You can also see I created a planner sticker sheet too in exactly the same way, but in graphics, I searched for planner sticker, found one I liked, looked at all the magic recommendations to pull in some more that would work, and then I came up with a color palette that I thought was super fun and changed the colors of all of the stickers to match that cohesive color palette. So now it's time to get ready to print and cut these out. The first thing I want to do is separate my two layers. So I'm going to duplicate this page, and then I'm going to delete all of the stickers from one page and the background from the other page. Now I'm going to show you two different methods for downloading these. One, if you do have a Canva Pro account, and then the other, if you don't. If you don't have a Canva Pro account, I really do highly recommend it. I use Canva and the Pro features every single day, but I'm going to show you a workaround. It isn't perfect, but it does work still. So if you do have a Canva Pro account, we're going to go to Share and then Download, and you are going to choose to download these two sheets as a PNG and check the transparent background box, and that will make sure that it is transparent. So when you upload this sheet to Cricut, Cricut will only see the stickers or the sheets and will only cut around the outside edge of them. But what if you don't have a Canva Pro account? Well, let me show you a workaround to do this with Cricut. We're going to do the same thing again by downloading these two sheets as a PNG, but you won't be able to check that transparent background box. So again, download both of them, save them onto your computer or laptop, and now it's time to upload them into Cricut. So we're going to go into Cricut and start a new project. Let's upload our sticker sheets one by one. So I'm going to upload and then upload image and browse and find where I've saved them. I'm going to upload, first of all, the sticker sheets with a transparent background. So following the steps to upload these sheets and then continue and then upload. And you'll have to do this with the stickers separately too. So you're going back again and now finding the sticker element, so the sticker layer, and then again, the one with the transparent background, going all the way through to add it to the canvas. So I'm making sure my sticker sheet, my sticker layer, lines up on the top of the sheets. Let's move them out of the way for now because I want to show you now what happens if we do the same thing again but with the PNGs that don't have the transparent background. So upload them again one by one, the sticker sheets first. I then have the option to remove that background manually. So if I click on any of the white area on the outside edge, it's going to make that transparent. But if you have a pattern or anything else in this design that also features either a really light color or white, it's going to potentially remove that too. Now, I'm going to be printing and cutting these on white sticker paper, so I'm okay with that. It looks fine. And now let's upload the stickers in the same way. And we've ran into a little bit of an issue here that I wanted to show you because the pale pink is so pale that Cricut didn't recognize it and it's removed it, made it transparent. So I could go back into Canva now, change that color to a darker one or a bolder one, and then do the same thing again. Or you could manually restore the color of those sections that we didn't want to be removed. So if there's anything that's light colored or white that has been made transparent, you can use the restore brush to bring it back. I honestly don't really have the time and the patience for that. But like I say, this is an imperfect workaround. So if you want to do that, you can. The white offset that I've added around my stickers has also been removed. And again, that's fine because I can add offsets back in again when I get this onto my Cricut canvas. So see if that works for you and let me know. I'm going to go back again now and be working with my PNGs that did have the transparent background. So let's bring them back into the canvas. I'll select both of those two layers, attach them together, and then you can see the red exclamation point. That's telling me that it's too big for the canvas, but I can click on the auto resize to make sure that they do work perfectly. Now, Cricut is going to kiss cut these stickers out. I want to be able to individually peel my stickers off the sticker sheets, but I would like Cricut to cut around the outside edge of the big sticker sheets so it cuts all the way through and die cuts them. Now to do that, what we can do is add some more layers of those backing sheets so that then Cricut will cut around each of those layers until it cuts all the way through the paper. So let's detach those two layers for now and then I'll duplicate that backing layer another couple of times so I've got three of them all together and then I'll align them at the top and the left so they're all neatly aligned. I can bring my stickers then on top and again make sure that the stickers are in the right position on those sheets and then select all of those layers and the stickers and attach them together. And now we're ready to print and cut them out. So let's click make. Everything is looking good here and continue, and we're going to send to printer. So I'm going to be printing on my Canon Pixmar. I'll turn off the bleed and turn on system dialog so I can change the print quality to high and then print my stickers out. Now I'm going to position these neatly onto my Cricut Joy Xtra cutting mat. I'm using the printable stickers setting that I really love and that works well for kiss cutting my stickers, and I'll change the pressure to less, and then we can hit go. Okay, time to see how our stickers have cut out. So I'm going to peel away the outside edge of that sticker sheet. Do this carefully. You want to make sure that you did die cut those sheets. And if not, then you might need to send it through to cut again. But everything is looking good. And now I can turn my mat over, pull down the corner of the sticker sheet, and then peel the mat away from the sheet to keep the stickers really nice and flat so we're not bending them. They're looking so good, and let's see how these stickers peel up. I love these penguin designs. Great job, Canva. These are so cute. This one says, hi. And let's see how the planner stickers have done too. We want them to be kiss cut out so that we can use these in our planner to decorate and organize. And this one is peeling up perfectly too. This is such a fun and easy way to make your own sticker sheet, whether you're making them for yourself or to share with loved ones or even to sell. And I really hope you've enjoyed learning how to make them step by step. Now, do use the template I've created for you because it makes your life so much easier. It's pre-sized and all you need to do is add your own designs. So just go to mimjenkinson.com/canva stickers and you can get your sticker sheet template and start to design your own sticker sheets. Make sure you share them on Instagram and tag me at Mim Jenkinson, because I would love to see them and celebrate your sticker making success. Thanks for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.